We will discuss the term income. Now, when we discuss the term income, generally we will understand income means it is a situation, or you can say it is inflow of cash. There is a possibility of cash coming in or cash comes in. That is a situation. So, based on this inflow, we have categorized, or we categorize this income as three: capital income, revenue income, and deferred income. Now, what is capital income? Capital income basically is irregular in nature. It is irregular in nature. Now, you can say the examples of capital incomes would be amount invested by owners, amount invested by owners, amount invested by owners. Basically, we have referred the amount invested by owner as capital. So, what is capital? Capital is nothing but amount invested by the owner. Owner will not bring the money on a regular basis, like every day or every month or every year. Occasionally, based upon his predictions or his, what you can say, projections, he brings in the money. So, therefore, inflow is irregular. So, when inflow is irregular, it is called as capital income. Now, other examples of this capital income would be, loans, you can say, or amounts received by sale of fixed asset, amounts received by sale of fixed assets, etc. At a complex business organizations or bigger business organizations, you can take debentures, bonds, etc., etc., also as capital incomes. Now, what is a revenue income? Now, essentially, the inflows are regular in nature. One of the features of revenue income is inflows are regular in nature. Number two, you can say they are periodical. Sometimes they are periodical. Periodical means you might receive on a daily basis or weekly basis or monthly, quarterly, half yearly, or at least compulsorily once in 1 year. So, when there is a regular inflow of cash, at least once in every 1 year, we categorize it as revenue income. Some of the examples of your revenue incomes would be amounts what you get through sales, that is sale of goods, amount what you get through sale of goods, the inflow of cash that comes in because of sale of goods, or you receive commission sometimes for your services given. So, that is also your revenue income. Or sometimes you have extra space to let out, so you have let it out, so you receive rent. So, rent received is also your revenue income. So, these are some of the examples of your revenue income. Now, what is deferred revenue income? What is deferred revenue income? Just like deferred revenue expenditure, you have your deferred revenue income. For example, you have your revenue income which has to be spread over more than one accounting year, then we say it is called as deferred revenue income. For example, let us assume rent received. Now, I'll take examples of 2 years. Suppose you have entered into an agreement with your tenant on, let us assume, on 1st July 2017. On 1st July, you have entered into agreement with your tenant. Now, your account, as discussed, our accounting year, let us assume, is beginning on 1st January 2017. So, accounting year is usually for 12 months. So, it will end on 31st December 2017. So, our accounting year is starting on January 1st, 2017 and ending on 31st December 2017. Now, we discussed that we have entered into a rental agreement with our tenant on 1st July 2017. That means your agreement or your terms and conditions, let us assume your tenant has to give 1 year rent on this date. On this date, on the beginning of the year, that is your rent year, rental year is starting on 1st July. So, it will end on 30th June 2018. So, rent received here for 12 months. Now, let us assume it is 12,000 rupees. Now, if you see this, this year is starting, the rental year according to you is starting on 1st July 2017 and it will end on 30th June 2018. 30th June 2018. That means you have received already rent for 12 months. So, this 12 months rent 12,000, you have to divide between your accounting year and this rental year for our convenience. So, that is, let us say you have to see 6 months is falling in accounting year. So, if 6 months rent has to be divided for this accounting year, that means you are treating 6,000 as current year revenue income. Now, the remaining portion is the rental income for the next accounting year. So, what is the rent of next accounting year? 6 months next year. Or rather, next accounting year, I will say. So, that is how much? 6,000. So, whatever is the rental income of the next accounting year is called as deferred revenue income. Whatever is the rental income of next accounting year is called as your deferred revenue income. The rental income which belongs to next accounting year is becoming our deferred revenue income. Now, based on this, later you will be seeing this revenue income of 6 months of this accounting year will be shown in your P&L account. Now, similarly, this rental income of the next accounting year, which is deferred revenue income, you will be showing in the balance sheet as liability. You will be showing it in the balance sheet of this year as a liability.